Hello and welcome back once again. So in this video, we are going to comment certain areas of our material to make them easier to read later on. And then we will do some fancy stuff to make the little crevices optionally glow if we want them to glow. So actually, for now, they are just going to glow. We will change that later by way of a material instance, which is something I'll talk about in a later video. So for now, let's go ahead and just get these things commented. So all of these nodes that you see up here are really driving our base color. So just to kind of run through it, we have our wood texture, which we are multiplying by a value of red. And that just gives us some nice red areas that have kind of a wood grain to them. And then we are linear interpolating between that result and the wood result, just the plain wood result. And as you can see in this tiny little preview cell, that gives us some tiles that are red, while the rest of the tiles look like they're just bare wood. Then we have the same thing going on twice. We have a blue section. So we have the wood grain color multiplied by blue. And then we're simply linear interpolating from our red result and this new color by way of the blue channel from our ceramic tile. So we end up with some tiles that are red, some tiles that are blue, and some tiles that are just plain regular wood. We multiply all of that by the grout color, or just kind of like a little darkening for the inside of the grooves. And so we end up with a nice indentation that is also kind of colored in between each one of our colored tiles. So let's take all of these nodes. I'm just going to marquee select all around them. And I'll hit the C key, and that's going to create a comment box. Now, comment boxes are very cool, and they will help you later on after you leave this material and come back. So let's see. This controls the color of our material. So we can see that even if we zoom away, we get a little bubble. If we get right up on it, that bubble goes away. But here's the really cool part that I love the most. You can resize this if you want to. You can come over to the comment color and you can change the color of it to anything you like. And when you're happy, you can also put your mouse right up here at the top and move the comment block around, and all those nodes come along with it. So as long as you see that little two-way cross, you can kind of move that around and reorganize your entire network, which is very, very useful. Okay, so the other one that we'll put, let's put another comment around these nodes. We'll hit C, and this controls the normal map. Slide that out of the way. We'll get these two guys really close to each other, select them both and hit C. And we'll just keep this fairly simple. Since this is just controlling our roughness, we'll just select it and say roughness. And yeah, it's just one node, but we'll just put a little node that says metallic. And we'll leave it as a comment just in case we want to make metallic interesting. Because just as a quick heads up, if you wanted to do something really fancy, totally optional, what if you wanted your red panels to suddenly be metallic? You could totally do that. You could just create a quick linear interpolate, like tap the L key, and let's say we lerp between a value of 0 and 1, which are default values. So you can see A is 0, B is 1 over here in the details panel. So if we take our green channel, which is, that's what's defining where our red panels go, we can just connect that over here into the alpha. And we can drive our metallic by that. And now if you take a look, all of our red channels look like they're metallic. Now, I'm not going to keep that. I just wanted to point that out because it is kind of nifty. For now, we'll just leave a metallic of 0 plugged in. And it'll just be like painted wood. All right, so that gives us all of the commenting we need. We have one more thing we're going to do, and that is create an emissive color. Now, I'm going to clear out a little bit of a work area right about here. And I'm going to grab our ceramic tile color sample, and or texture sample, I should say. I'm going to hit Control-C and paste a copy of that over here. Notice when you paste, the node appears at the location the mouse was when you hit Control-V, which is very, very useful. And you should definitely use that to your advantage. Now, we have one of the channels in here, just to, as a quick review. If we show the red channel, it is just the kind of grout or gaps between the tiles. However, there's a catch. If we zoom in, there's a lot of like raw, like I guess kind of like worn areas that you can see. I don't know if you can make that out in the video. If you can't, don't worry. It'll be really apparent here in just a moment. What I'm gonna do is take that information from the red channel and I'm going to invert it. What is white is gonna become black. What is black is gonna become white. And the way you do that is with a 1- node. So I'm gonna drag a wire off here and just type 1-. Like so, and if we take a look at the preview, you can see that if we right click and just say start previewing that, you can see what it looks like. And now you can see all of that problematic stuff, because I don't want that. All of that gray that's showing up on each tile, we want that to be gone. Now the way we're gonna get rid of that is with a material function. Now over here in the palette, we have more than just nodes. We have entire functions, which are complete snippets of code. In effect, they are entire node networks that are condensed down to a single node. And I don't want to get too far into that because that is its own discussion that could take plenty of time to go through. But what I want you to do is here in the palette, type contrast. And there's a cheap contrast node. Just drag that in. Cheap is always good. And plug the result of your 1- to the input. And then let's start previewing this guy. Now, the cheap contrast will take in an input. His default value is 0, so we need to assign a number to this. So hold down the 1 key and click right behind these nodes, and that'll create a constant value, which I'll go ahead and condense down and just make it small. We'll plug this into contrast and then set the value to, I don't know, let's try 2. Oh, that's too much. Let's try a value of 1. All right, let's try 0.5. Warmer, we're getting there. Notice we're starting to get the gaps back in, but all that noise that was on each panel is pretty much gone. So let's try like 0.1. Perfect, look at that. That's exactly what I wanted. I have a really nice picture that just shows where those gaps are. So just use cheap contrast with a contrast value of about 0.1. Now, we need to create the color that we'll use to make all these things glow. I like orange. So let's hold down the 3 key and click, and we'll double click our little color swatch and choose a nice reddish orange, like so. Now we're gonna take that color and multiply it by our cheap contrast result. So drag a wire from cheap contrast and type multiply, or if you want, if you're a hotkey person, you can hold down the M key and click, and then boom, and boom. And if we take a look at that, you can see we now end up with a grid that is primarily orange. So we need to right click and actually preview that if you want to see it, because it's so tiny. Now that looks nice, but it's not going to be very glowy. And I can prove that to you. If we grab all these guys and slide them back a little bit, and let's make this nice and small once again. Let's stop previewing. I'll right click on the multiply and choose stop previewing. And we'll plug that into emissive color. And it's there, it's like it's kind of glowing, but it's not really glowing. So we're gonna make it really glow. And to do that, we're gonna multiply it by another number. So let's drag a wire out and choose multiply. And then let's make another constant value. I'll hold down the 1 key and click. And let's set this to something like 10 for starters. So we'll plug this value of 10 into my B input, like so, and take the output of the multiply and plug that into emissive. Woohoo, check it out. So now that glow has become a lot more intense and we can keep lifting it higher. So let's take our 10 and set it to something like 20. And now it's really getting bright. Or we can set it to 30. Or even 100. And now you see we're actually starting to get some color bloom blowing out of the surface as well. Not the most practical material in the world, but it is fun and it does show you a lot of cool things that you can do within the material editor. So now let's grab all of these nodes. We'll just tap the C key and write emissive. Let's slide this out of the way and let's hit the apply button. And there we go. So we have a series of wooden tiles that have all been colorized, and they are emitting a glow from between all of them. Kind of an out there material, not gonna lie, it's a little bit different, but again, it does show off some really, really nifty techniques. So that is going to wrap things up for this video. And in the next video, we'll take a look at instancing materials so that we can make variations of a single material. That'll wrap things up here. Thanks a lot.